As usual, Ash, will be a big event. It will be very different this year, being virtual rather than in person. I have not had a huge amount of time to scan the abstracts, but one that has caught my attention is one by the Children's Oncology Group, where they analyze a huge cohort of more than 21,000 patients to look for risk factors. And this really caught my eye because it built upon a risk score or prognostic index that we had developed in the UK a few years ago and published earlier this year in Blood. And essentially what it does is it takes diagnostic cytogenetics, white cell count and MRD at the end of induction. And you can use those four variables to plug into an equation and calculate an individualized risk score, which you can then use to predict that individual patient's risk of relapse. We had developed this prognostic index on patients treated on UCAL 2003 in the UK and then validated it on an equal size cohort of around 2,400 patients from several European trials. However, what the Americans have done now is they've then validated this prognostic index even further on this huge cohort of over 21,000 patients, and they found that it works very well and hence validates. So that's a real boost for kind of coming up with novel ways of risk stratifying pediatric patients with acute lymphoblastic leukemia, because the key element of this prognostic index is it is a continuous variable and it correlates directly with the risk of relapse. And therefore, what you can do is you can use that risk score or prognostic index to define risk groups of any size and outcome that you need for your next trial. So if you decide that you want to treat the best performing 50% of patients with chemotherapy regime A, you can do that. You can easily identify those patients. Similarly, the other end of the spectrum, if you decide that you want to give experimental therapies or novel therapies only to those patients have a relapse risk of, say, more than 40%. It is quite easy to calculate that using this continuous prognostic index and identify those patients. So this does kind of open up a new era in the design of risk stratification algorithms for future trials of pediatric ALL. And indeed potentially adult ALL as well. So we were really pleased that abstract has been published, and I'm looking forward to hearing that talk.